Here is the complete timeline of the brotherhood between Mako and Bolin.
We were orphans out on the street. I did what I had to do to survive and protect my little brother.
This isn't the time to prove how awesome you are. I already know how awesome you are.
Growing up as orphans in Republic City, Mako and Bolin did what they had to survive.
Hey, come back here!
Even when that meant running scams on the citizens of the city.
Give it back, you dirty thief!
Hey! I stole that fair and square! Ow! Stop it! Oof! Okay, you win!
Your purse, ma'am.
Aren't you a little hero? Here, let me give you a reward.
The brothers even worked for the criminal organization, the Triple Threat Triads. During this time, Mako often had to teach Bolin that in order to survive, he had to have a thick skin.
Please, we can't just leave him for snake food.
Bolin, you have to toughen up. Big animals eat the little animals. That's just how it goes.
Especially when Bolin saw his hero, Toza, agreeing to take a fall in the upcoming pro bending match.
I'm gonna hate to see Toza lose, even if he means to.
Why? He got paid. You didn't see any pro benders crying for us when mom and dad died and we got dumped on the street. Life is hard. You either hustle or get hustled.
Eventually, Bolin also taught Mako that while having a thick skin was important, it also didn't hurt to show a little compassion.
Come on, we should get out of here.
No, not without him.
All right, but his food comes out of your half.
And that compassion paid off when Toza took the pair under his wing, allowing them to finally leave the Triple Threats.
I could find you a place to stay right here in the arena. Who knows? You could be champs. At least it's a chance at an honest living.
Can we, Mako? Mako, can we please?
Don't go soft on me, Mako. Remember, it's up to you to take care of your little brother. Use your head. Make the smart play.
Sorry, Shady, but you're right. I do have to take care of my brother, and I think this is what's best for him.
With Toza's help, they honed their skills and formed their own pro-bending team.
Introducing the Fire Ferrets!
I love you, Bolin!
But it was only once the Avatar, Korra, joined them.
Don't do anything too fancy or aggressive. In fact, don't do anything. Just try not to get knocked off the ring.
You got it, Captain.
That their team felt truly complete. Ah! But that was also the start of a complicated love triangle.
What do you think of Korra in a girlfriend sort of way?
She's great, but I think it makes more sense for me to go for Asami.
I was talking about a girlfriend for me. Leave some ladies for the rest of us.
I know, it's what I thought you meant. Bolin, this isn't what you think.
While it did trigger a rough patch between the brothers.
You're not my brother. You're a brother betrayer.
Their bond was far too strong to be broken that easily.
Are you okay?
Are we gonna be all right?
Of course we are. We're brothers. We'll get through this mess. I'm sorry.
Me too. Girls.
Seriously.
Thanks to some underhanded strategy by the Wolfbats, the Fire Ferrets lost in the finals. But the brothers found a greater calling in helping the Avatar take down Amon and protect Republic City.
Yeah, and remember, Aang hadn't mastered all the elements when he was battling the Fire Nation. He was just a little kid.
And he wasn't alone. He had his friends to help him. Look, the arena might be shut down, but we're still a team! The new Team Avatar!
We got your back, Korra. And we can save the city together.
Yeah, let's do it.
With peace brought back to the city, the two brothers went their separate ways for a bit. With Mako becoming a cop and Bolin struggling to keep the Fire Ferrets alive without him.
The Fire Ferrets go down in the water and right into the record books for the fastest knockout in pro bending history.
Where's Mako when I need him?
But it didn't stop Mako from giving some big brother advice to Bolin about relationships.
Ending a relationship is kind of like pulling off a blood-sucking leech. You just gotta rip it off and get it over with. You'll feel a lot better afterwards, trust me.
Thanks, Mako. Whew, I'm lucky you're so good at breaking girls' hearts.
With Bolin becoming a mover star and Mako getting deeper into his police work, their different goals did put a bit of a strain on their brotherly bond.
I don't have time to take a dippity dip, okay? I'm trying to catch who's ever been attacking the shipments and I need your help.
You need my help? Ugh, I don't know. I'm kind of busy.
You're sitting in a hot tub.
I'm maintaining my instrument. As an actor, my body is my instrument.
Are you gonna help or not?
You know, I recall a time when I needed your help and you basically told me to get a life.
So that's a no. What am I supposed to do now?
I don't know, Mako.
Figure it out. Remember? That's what you said to me. Hurts, doesn't it?
But when Mako's police work led him to be wrongfully imprisoned, he still tried to warn his little bro about the impending danger.
Bolin, wait. If my theory about Varric is right, something might go down tonight at your premiere. Promise me you'll keep your eyes peeled.
Yeah, okay, big brother.
Although Bolin just wouldn't listen.
Whew, that insanity defense is definitely gonna work.
Until he saw it for himself and realized that Mako was right all along.
Tell me who sent you!
It was Varric. Please don't hurt me, Nuk-Tuk!
So when Mako's name was finally cleared, it was Bolin who personally delivered the good news.
You were right about Varric! He tried to kidnap Raiko!
I knew it!
But it didn't work because of you and because of me. Let's just say we both did good. Beifong says you're free to go.
Remember when Mako gave Bolin relationship advice? Well, now it was Bolin's time to return the favor.
Have you told Corey yet about how you guys broke up and then you kind of started dating Asami while she was off getting attacked by dark spirits?
You want to keep it down? I'm waiting for the right moment.
Oh, Mako. You know, a wise man once told me that delivering bad news to a girlfriend was like ripping off a blood-sucking leech. You just have to do it fast and get it over with.
I hate it when you listen to me.
It had been a while since the pair fought side by side, but even so, they proved to still be an incredible fighting team as they reunited for this epic battle. So when it was time for the Avatar to take on her biggest threat yet, Unalaq, it was these bending brothers that she trusted to take him on. While the battle may not have gone exactly as planned, this hardship only strengthened and rejuvenated their bond. After peace was restored once again, it seemed the pair would return to their separate ways. When Bolin planned to go with Korra to Ba Sing Se, Mako planned to stay behind. But of course, with a little encouragement from little bro, his mind was changed.
We need you! Come on, Mako, we're going to Ba Sing Se where Dad grew up. What if I meet our grandma for the very first time? And she asks me, "Where's your sweet brother?" And I have to say, "I'm sorry, Grandma. He had some really important police paperwork to file." And she starts to cry those grandma tears and is like, "Mako, why, Mako? I can't go on, I can't." And then she dies.
Okay, all right, I'll come with you.
It was there, in Ba Sing Se, that they learned about their own heritage and history as they were reunited with long-lost family.
Hey, everybody, look who's here. San's kids, Mako and Bolin.
No way!
Come in!
Welcome.
Is it true? After all these years? This is the only letter we ever got from San. It says he married a beautiful girl from the Fire Nation and had two wonderful sons. He sent this picture of you all on his birthday.
Look, Mako! Dad's wearing your scarf.
I'm so sad that I never got to meet your mother. But you have her eyes. I know from looking at you two that she must have been a wonderful bride for my boy.
I'm sure they would want you to have this.
But with their family, they learned some troubling news.
They say the Earth Queen's locking all the airbenders up somewhere and using them for experiments.
And decided that they were most needed back with Team Avatar.
We have to get back to the Upper Ring and tell Korra.
And they were right, because it wasn't long before Korra was attacked by the Red Lotus. And it was up to these two brothers to get her back. When it all came down to Bolin specifically to save the day, only Mako's brotherly support could give Bolin the confidence to do what he had to do.
It's Bolin time.
Bolin, take the shot!
And it helped Bolin believe in himself, and he was able to hit his mark.
Haha, nice job, little bro.
But unfortunately, the battle led the brothers to be captured and thrown in an Earth Kingdom prison.
We have to find a way out of here before Zaheer gets his hands on Korra.
Since Mako's coaching helped Bolin once, he thought he'd try again to give Bolin the confidence to try his hand at metal bending.
Bolin, this is up to you. I know you can metal bend.
You can metal bend? No.
Yes, you can. I believe in you.
I believe in you too, Bolin.
I appreciate that, Mako, and fellow prisoner man, but I've been trying and trying and trying, and I've never been able to do it. Not even a little.
You've always had the ability deep down. You just haven't had the right motivation. But this is your time. Get us out of here to save Korra. You can do it. Bolin! Bolin!
Bolin! Bolin! Bolin!
Did you see that? I did it! I mean, not for us, but I metal bent all the other cells open!
I don't think that was you.
But after multiple failures, Bolin was left discouraged. It's a good thing the brothers turned out to be useful to Zaheer.
I'm going to set you free, but I want to talk to you first. I have a message that I need you to take to Korra.
While on the surface, Mako's metal bending encouragement didn't seem to help, turns out that it may have just been the self-confidence boost Bolin needed to face down a deadly wave of molten lava. And in the heat of the moment, discover an inner strength he never knew he had.
Incredible.
You're a lava bender.
I know. I just found out.
Over the next 3 years, the brothers took separate paths once again, leading them to be on opposite sides of a military conflict.
You aren't going to keep working for Kuvira now that she's going against the wishes of the entire world, are you?
You don't understand. Kuvira is helping out all the poor people in the Earth Empire.
By crushing anyone who gets in your way?
That was just some tough rhetoric to let the people know that we mean business.
It seems like she's just a dictator who's taking the Earth Kingdom by force.
Okay, so you think your new best friend in there would be a better leader than Kuvira?
Well, no, but still—
Still what? Come on, Mako, I'm making a difference out there. What are you doing, huh?
I'm sorry. I don't want to work for your glorious emperor and her military dictatorship.
Fine. I'm going to go back to my awesome train where we bring freedom wherever we go. Enjoy licking the king's boots in your junior suite!
But by now, their bond had grown so strong that once Bolin escaped Kuvira's inner circle, the forgiveness between the two brothers was full and immediate.
Bolin, I'm so glad you're back. I was worried about you.
We all were.
Thanks, guys. Mako, I'm so sorry about the way we left things. I'm such an idiot. You tried to warn me about Kuvira, and I ran off anyway, like an idiot. You were right, and I'm just an idiot. I hope that I'll be able to earn your trust again.
Bolin, you're not an idiot. You were just doing what you thought was right.
Oh, I love you guys. And I really want to hug again.
So it was time for them to join together for one last fight to take down the military threat in one epic battle inside a colossal super weapon.
I'm ready!
be with you in 1 second! Kinda busy! Okay, ready now!
And it was during this fight that you could clearly see just how strong their bond truly was.
I'm gonna zap these vines with some electricity.
Let's back it up, okay? I said that will make the vines explode.
Exactly. This is our only way of shutting this thing down. I can handle it.
No, you can't! This isn't the time to prove how awesome you are! I already know how awesome you are! You're awesome!
I don't have time to argue! I'm doing this! So get out of here!
Okay. But for the record, I do not approve. Just get out as soon as you can. Promise?
Promise.
Because through all the conflict and hardship and battle, the one constant that remained for both of them was that they always had each other.
Bolin's the only family I have left.
And that no matter what happened, the brotherhood that bonds them together is stronger than anything that life could throw at them.
I love you.
I love you too.
What's your favorite brotherly moment? Let us know in the comments below.